It seems that there is an open consensus in neuroscience that the perception that we have free will is an illusion. A widely known neuroscientist, Dr. Robert Sapolsky, said recently that even our love choices are determined by our genetics and our life's experiences. Do you agree that we are locked in by an inherently lack of free will?
This is definitely a theme that has been creating controversies. Well, we have the perception that most of the time we have the control of our choices. But the controversy rises when neuroscientists bring views that from the conception, every input that our brain receives in interaction with our genetics determines the choices we make. Our sense of smell, for instance, is heavily influenced by our genetics, and no one can deny that smell is a very important factor when it comes to the attraction we feel for other people, right? And this is a simple example, because we can have genetic influences that shape even our aesthetic sense. It's not about highlighting which type of influence is more or less decisive, but the center of the matter is, do we have the power to change the course of our lives in any given moment? We know the idea of total free will has already been strongly refuted because of these discoveries about the relationship between genetics, environment, and brain structure. Also, the importance we now know these brain circuits have in shaping our memories and in the development of our emotional and social brain systems are directly connected to all of this. The body of knowledge that leads neuroscience to lean towards denying the validity of our experience of free will is quite robust and is tied to research in each area of brain function, which is the core subject of neuroscience. But there remains a small space for us to discuss the role of consciousness in our choices, and there we can find different interpretations.